Hi, welcome to Remedy Messenger's Kids Corner. Today we're going to have an interesting story to bring for you today. I have Amaya helping me. I have Kayla helping me. We're relaxing on the floor and just having a good time talking about the Bible. Right, girls?
Yeah.
Silly goose. So today we're going to talk about Jonah. And Jonah was a prophet in the Bible. And the story starts with God speaking to Jonah and saying, Jonah, I want you to go to Nineveh and minister to my people. Now, did Jonah want to go to Nineveh?
No.
So what did he do?
He went the opposite way.
So Jonah said, hey, I'm going to flee. I'm going to go to Joppa, and I'm going to get on a ship, and I'm going to go the opposite way.
And he tried to hide from God.
Now, can you really hide from God?
No. God's everywhere.
He's everywhere. He's everywhere all the time. But he tried. So we'll keep reading and we'll keep talking about the story here. So he got on the boat and he's trying to go the opposite way and he fell asleep and he's sound asleep. He's thinking, hey, my plan is working. Okay. But there's a major storm that starts going and the sailors get nervous and they're throwing stuff over the boat and they're praying to their gods to try to get a change. And did a change happen? No. So they run down to Jonah. Jonah, hey, wake up. Pray to your God. There's something going on. There's a storm. We're going to wreck if something doesn't change. And finally, Jonah tells them, hey, guys, at the end of the day, I'm running away from God. This is because of my God. And he goes, what? If you throw me over the boat, the sea will become calm and your boat won't wreck.
And so he jumped. You got eaten by a whale.
Oh, you're right, but you're going a little bit too fast. Let's slow down for a second. So the sailors are nervous, but they do throw them over the boat, and they actually ask the Lord our God to forgive them if they've done something wrong. But once they throw Jonah over the boat, the sea does calm, and it stops. And they're in such awe that they actually start serving our Lord, the Lord God of Jonah, right? And so anyways, Jonah, though, when he gets thrown over, he gets swallowed by a whale. And he's in the belly of the whale for how long, Kayla?
3 days and three nights.
3 days and three nights he's in the belly of the whale. And while he's in there, he's praying and he's talking to God and he's having a conversation. And finally, after 3 days and three nights are over, the whale throws him up on dry land. And guess what God says? Does anybody know what God tells him at that time? What is it, Kayla?
Go to Nineveh.
Go to Nineveh and preach to my people. So finally, Jonah submits and he goes to Nineveh and he preaches to the people. And he tells them, look, your land's going to be destroyed. You guys have been doing evil and God is not happy with this land and he's going to destroy it. Now, did the people listen or did they go, you're just talking smoke. We don't have to listen to you. Did they listen to him or not?
They listened.
They did listen. In fact, they listened so well that they decided to start wearing sackcloth and they fasted. They denied themselves something they liked so that they can get closer to God and ask him for repentance, ask him for forgiveness for the things that they've done, the bad things that they've done. Okay. And it went so high up that even the king made a decree that no man, woman, or animal could eat. Okay. They all had to wear sackcloth and get before God and fast and repent, ask for forgiveness for things that they have done. And God saw that and saw their hearts. And he forgave them. He forgave his people that were doing bad and doing evil. He forgave their bad deeds. Isn't that awesome?
Yeah.
Have you guys ever done something bad and you hope your parents forgive you for what you've done? Yeah. We all appreciate mercy and grace, and we all need to learn how to repent from when we do things that are not right. And so this is a great example of how that they went and asked forgiveness and God forgave them. Okay. And there are a couple of things that we want to take away from this story. We'll stop there and we'll talk about the takeaways from this story. So one thing is disobedience gets us in trouble, doesn't it? We can't be disobedient. If our authority tells us to do something and it's correct, we need to make sure we follow what our authority says. Okay? Our parents, our teachers, the authority that's over us, we need to make sure we listen to them. Also, we learn from this story that God is compassionate, okay? Because the people of Nineveh are not necessarily Hebrews or Israelites. They're of a different culture. But God still had mercy on them. And after they repented, he gave forgiveness and he was merciful. And that's what we all need in our lives. We need to learn how to be quick to repent. We need to be merciful and learn how to forgive quickly. Okay? And make sure we're not disobedient to our authorities. Anything else that we learned from this story, girls? I think that's it. Thank you. Thank you for joining us. We hope you enjoyed the story about Jonah. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.